sharp words directed at Canada Monday. In China's first public response to their release of Canadians Michael Spavor and Michael Kovrig, who were detained by Beijing for more than 1,000 days. China's foreign ministry says Canada should learn a lesson and not do dirty work for the U.S. The Michaels touched down here at home on Saturday. China claiming Monday they were released after seeking bail for medical reasons, denying a link to Chinese Huawei executive Meng Wanzhou. She was allowed to return to China after reaching a deferred prosecution agreement with U.S. prosecutors on Friday. Meng was arrested at Vancouver International Airport on a U.S. extradition warrant in December 2018. And just days later, the two Canadians were detained in China and later faced espionage allegations. Their arrests widely seen as retribution and an act of hostage politics, which Beijing has denied. With tensions running high for years now, this expert says it's undeniable the relationship between Canada and China has deteriorated.
I think there's been a lot of damage over the last almost 3 years. Positive image of China is at an all-time low, somewhere in low double, very low double digits. And I don't think it's possible to expect a rubber band like snap back to where things were.
The White House press secretary was asked by reporters Monday about the release of the two Michaels.
The action here, deferring the charges linked to the release of the two Canadians, doesn't that create sort of an incentive structure that would give China more reason to do this sort of thing again?
I think it's important to note and to be very clear about this. There is no link. We have an independent Justice Department. We can't determine how the Chinese or others manage their business over there. It's a little bit different, but we have an independent Justice Department that made independent decisions, law enforcement decisions. At the same time, we have made no secret about our push to have the two Michaels released. That's certainly positive news and good news.
Melissa Duggan, City News.